Hi there. So I just was looking back on this video and I found a comment asking me to make a video on how to download the emulator and everything else to get it properly running. And I thought, yeah, I can do that. So actually, in this video, I've got all the links you need in the description, but here I'm going to run through everything you need to do to get it all installed. So the first link is DeSmuME. This is the emulator that we'll be using, and the address is just desmume.org/download. You can find the download. It's just got the first two links here. So the first one here is the actual DeSmuME distributable. So I'm running on Windows 64, so I'm going to just download this one. And that is going in my new folder, which I just made. So that's, I'll just save the zip here. Once that's downloaded, I'll open it up. I have 7-zip installed, so I'm just gonna tell 7-zip to extract it into its own folder here. Delete that zip file, so that should contain the emulator here, so that's all good. The second link on here is needed to run the emulator, so I'll download this too. That goes to this page, and I'll download this zip here, stick it in the same folder. And I'll do the same thing, so I'll just extract it to its own folder in here. And this executable should install you the prerequisites that you need to run the emulator. And that should be done now. So if I go into the emulator folder and just double click this, here we have a Nintendo DS emulator. So that's step one. Second step is the game, which you can get by clicking this link, the second link here. I will put all these links again in the description of this video. And that takes us here to the Bionicle Heroes page on Biomedia Project. And this is actually, so if you're worried, this isn't piracy at all. It's the ROM for this game was actually supplied by the LEGO group to Biomedia Project so that we can all share it and use it. So that's really cool of them. So we just click on the DS link here, and that comes up with an NDS file. And I'll save that into my folder here too. So that's there. Now, if I go into my BHDS demo folder, that's here now. It's already assigned that as DeSmuME as to open it. I'm not sure if that will happen by default, so I'll just show you through the emulator if we open it up here. And then we do File, Open ROM. And then we can just open that. And this is what you get. So I'm gonna do a little bit of quick setup here. So I like to have the LCDs layout horizontally. And then I change the window size as well. To have this screen size ratio to 1.4 to 0.6. That blacks it out here. In the 3D settings, I change the renderer to OpenGL 3.2, set the GPU scaling factor to 4, and texture scaling to 4, and the color depth to 24-bit. And now this will sort of increase the graphical quality of it when you're looking at the 3D scenes. Obviously all the 2D sprites will still look exactly as they used to. I'm also going to turn on anti-aliasing and tick the smooth textures button. Now this might vary depending on how good your computer is. Mine is fairly capable, so I don't really see any problems with this when I run it on my own. So if I just skip past that cutscene, start a new game, let's just get as quickly into it. So far I'm just using the mouse and everything. I'm going to select right-handed key view, because that's what we need for later. It shouldn't matter too much with my script, but for safety, pick that one. And we'll tick there, level select, jump straight into Sky Temple. So, this is what we see. Obviously, I can't really move it much. I'm using the keyboard. And it's all based on the sort of Nintendo control layout. So if I press A, it moves, and if I press X, it moves the other way. And if I tap the screen, it jumps. And that's not exactly easy to use. So what we shall do, if we close this then, the third link I'll show you is the script for Xbox 360 controller support. Now, if I go in here, I've actually got a README in here which tells you how to get everything set up as well. This is everything you need in the folder. So if I just go to download zip, so if you press the code button here and then download zip, and I'll save that here. I show that in the folder, extract it to its own place, and then I can clean up and delete it. If I look in here, so what we have here is the script itself. I've got a couple of screenshots for this README here. One of them is the controls. And now if I go into here, so the two included binaries, they need to be either in your environment path. I'm not going to show how to change your system environment path in this video, but it's fairly easy to Google. Or the other easier way is just to chuck them in the same directory as DeSmuME itself. So if I grab up here, copy those. Let's go into where the executable is. I'll just paste them here. So the next thing to do is just start up DeSmuME again, and we are going to change a couple more settings. So we're going to enable advanced bus level timing. I showed this in my README here. Essentially, it's a tool for, it's usually used for like tool assisted speedrunning, but we need it for this script, otherwise it can't sort of read the memory of where the player is and adjust the movement properly. In my version of DeSmuME, this was ticked already, but just make sure it's ticked and it should be fine. The next thing to do is in config and display method, you want to make sure OpenGL is ticked. Because we just changed the 3D settings to use the OpenGL renderer, it's going to run slow if we don't also tick OpenGL here. Plus the script for the controller will slow things down a little bit, so you want to make sure it's running as fast as possible. Also make sure you've got a controller plugged in, because then when you run the script it won't work otherwise. So yeah, so then finally if we just open up the game again, and then we go to Lua scripting, new Lua script window, browse for our script, and it's there. And it should just run. If it comes up with any errors, leave a comment on this video and I'll see if I can figure it out. But it should just work. So I skip this cutscene now. Load our game back up. Have a go. So I should now be able to go through things with the controller. So this is actually done with the Nintendo button setup. So if you're not familiar with that, A is B and B is A and X is Y and Y is X. If you're using a standard Xbox controller, I did it like that because the key view of Bionicle Heroes uses the sort of location of the buttons as sort of look buttons. So if I were to press A on a DS, it would look right, but obviously that is not where the A button is on the Xbox 360 controller, so I've switched them around. It's not too confusing if you don't look at the buttons, so that should be fine. So now if I just, I can use the sticks to select options on the menu, or I can use the D-pad. So if I press B, which is actually A, then I can load the game. So I load through the game, select level, I'll get back into Sky Temple, Snake's Gate. And now I can move around using, so the left analog stick is a nice smooth view movement. I can walk around with the right analog stick. I just said left and right wrong. So actually, left is move and right is looking around. So if I use right trigger, I can shoot things. And if I tap the right stick, I can jump. So that's the same as tapping on the screen there. I'm going to attempt to get up to hero mode so that I can show you that control. So for going through things like this, where you've got to use your toe's ability, it says the L button, and it's just the L trigger. And that should switch it over. And then you can use the abilities like that. So now I am ready to go hero mode. So the button for that is the left button. So that's the bumper, sorry, at the top there. So there we go. Now I'm overpowered. Should be able to take these guys down quite easily. And finally, the last thing to do is show you how to switch Toa. So once I've picked up this mask, I will have two Toa to choose from. And if you have them all next to each other, you can tap left and right D-pad, which will essentially, it taps on the button next to the one you've got on. Obviously that doesn't work when you've got some locked, so the other thing you can do is also press the select button. It's what would be the select button on the Nintendo DS, but it's actually the I think it's back on the Xbox 360 controller, so that will just toggle you through the ones you've got. And last but not least, because I was hacking through the movement controls in order to get this running, I've also added in a sprint button. So if I hold down right bumper, I can go extra fast. Just for fun. And there we are. That concludes my sort of setup demo video of the script. I hope you have fun, and again, let me know if you have any trouble and I'll do what I can to help you out. Bye.